Hello everyone, welcome back to the Going Zero Waste YouTube channel. I'm Catherine Kellogg, and today we're going over three easy steps for cleaning out your closet and defining your personal style. One of the videos that was requested a few videos back was me cleaning out my closet because it is something that I am still in the process of doing. It takes me a very long time to do this, and I'm not entirely sure how I'm gonna edit this video and keep it succinct and snappy because honestly, it's painful just living with myself doing this, let alone probably watching it, but I'm gonna try and make it snappy and succinct and entertaining just for you. Hi, this is the Catherine that edits the videos. We've made some slight changes here, but first, if you would please give this video a thumbs up. This video is gonna be more about how to change your mindset, what you should be thinking about, how to define your personal style, and how this is gonna help you in the future. If you would like a video that actually walks through me going through all of my clothes, trying them all on, and seeing that actual thought process, let me know in a comment down below and I'll work on that for next week. This video is just getting a little bit too long and felt like they deserved to be in two separate categories. But first, some facts. In the 1940s, the average woman had 9 outfits. In the 60s, on average, people only attained 10 new pieces of clothing a year. Now, each person receives roughly 70 new garments every single year. This has to do, of course, with the rise of fast fashion, which I've got a bunch of great blog posts on if you're interested in learning more about this. And let me know if you would like an educational video about the problems with fast fashion, and I can do that in another video. So let me know in the comment section down below. So even though we have more and more and more clothing pieces than we ever have before, most of us are as dissatisfied with our wardrobes as ever. We constantly look at them and think, I have nothing to wear. And why is that? Well, the number one reason that probably is because you're shopping for the person you want to be and not the person you are. This is something I fall into all the time. Being a person who is in theater, who loves clothing and costuming and characters, I view my wardrobe as my own personal costume box. And in fact, I actually have a small section in my office, a closet dedicated strictly to costume pieces because I want to dress up and just be a different person sometimes. And I thoroughly enjoy that. So this is like the hardest part for me, is really reining it all in and really truly defining my personal style. A really great way to break this cycle is to write down all the activities that you do in an average week or month. I know it's gonna be a little bit different now since most of us are stuck at home, but for me, currently, it would look like working from home and going to the grocery store. Those are, and taking Nala on a walk, and workout classes. So I do a workout class in my home, so obviously I'm gonna need workout gear for that. Working from home, I want something that's comfortable but still looks professional. And then going to the grocery store, which I do dress up for because I really personally really, really enjoy dressing up. So how that would look when I think about creating outfits is I would go to my closet and create outfits for all of those activities in mind. Then I would look what I have too much of and what I don't have enough of and fill in those gaps. And the thing is, when it comes to cleaning out your closet, you don't necessarily have to get rid of something just because you don't like it. Sometimes you might love something, but you don't wear it enough and you don't use it enough to justify holding on to it. And that's a good enough reason to let something go sometimes. And now you may be thinking, Catherine, I thought you were a zero waste person. I thought that you weren't interested in wasting things. And I would say yes. Zero waste and decluttering go hand in hand because the way I personally like to look at it is by redistributing your resources. Every single thing is a resource. And if you're not using or wearing something, then it's a resource that is going to waste. And you could otherwise redistribute that resource so someone else could be using it to its fullest potential. Doing things like selling your clothes, which is what I'm doing. I'm going through the process of selling my clothes right now so I can redistribute some of these resources and hope that people will get more use out of them than I'm currently getting out of them.
Also want to note that it's okay to have pieces in your closet that you don't wear that often. No one is holding you to a set number. What's most important is how you consume and bring things into your life and making sure that you're not overbuying or overspending and overconsuming new resources. But I definitely have some frivolous secondhand pieces in my wardrobe that I hardly ever wear, but they're not going anywhere because they just bring me joy, and that's okay too. Now back to other exercises on defining your personal style, because this is gonna help with the consumption of new pieces and also narrowing down your current wardrobe.
So defining your style, here is the best way that I think to go about it for me personally. I want you to put a timer on for 60 seconds, and I want you to write down the 5 pieces of clothing you have absolutely loved the most in your entire life. Are you ready, set, go? Okay, so I'm gonna assume that you paused the video and that you sat down, and in 60 seconds you came up with 3 to 5 pieces that you absolutely love. Now I want you to think about why you love those pieces. Why are those the pieces that came to mind? What are those feelings that you felt about them? Maybe you liked the shape of the item. Maybe you liked the feel of the item. Maybe you just liked the way the item looked on you, the color. Figure out what it is about you, figure out what it is that you love about each and every single one of those items. And then you can start to maybe get a pretty clear picture on what you like about clothing.
And on the flip side, when it comes to getting rid of an item, ask yourself why you didn't like that item. Was it because it was fussy? Was it because it didn't fit right? Was it because you weren't crazy about the color, the fit, the shape? Why didn't you like the item? And when you start building out both of these lists, you're gonna have a really clear picture on what you like and what you don't.
For me, I have learned a lot of things along the way. For instance, I really like the way things look when they accentuate my natural waistline. So what does that mean? It means that when it comes to shopping for clothes, I'm gonna make sure I pick up things that are accentuating my natural waistline. I really like natural fibers. And in fact, I find that I overheat in silk. I don't want anything that's too tight with cotton. I actually prefer tencel. I prefer linen. I prefer different materials. I've always shied away from button-down shirts because, like, God, I just don't really like the way they feel. But then I got this one in linen and I'm obsessed. I could wear it every single day. I love it so much. So when you figure out why you really like certain pieces, how they look on you, the materials you like, the colors you like to wear. As we addressed in my Valentine's video, I wear baby pink and baby blue almost every single day because I think I look fantastic in those colors. So now when I'm shopping, if I see something in emerald green, I'm probably just gonna hard pass immediately because I know, I prefer baby pink and baby blue. And if I see something in baby pink and baby blue, I'm probably gonna buy it because I know. And but by sticking to my playbook of things I know I like, it's gonna be easier for me to whittle down what I'm not using. It's gonna be easier to accept new pieces that are coming into my life. And now this is coming from a former shopaholic who used to buy a lot of clothes. So having these rules, regulations, and structures built in to what I'm buying, it was really gonna help me hone in on my purchases. Speaking of which, you should check out my video, 6 questions to ask yourself before you buy something. I think that's what it's called. I'm gonna link to it up here because this is a really important video, because whittling down and organizing and deep cleaning is the band-aid to the problem, not the solution to the problem. The solution to the problem is making sure that you're not bringing in things that you don't want, like, or don't use in the first place. So make sure you check out the video because this is simply to help course correct when things have gone wrong. That's the universe telling me that things have gone wrong. I know things have gone wrong. I haven't cleaned up my closet in like 4 to 5 years though. So they couldn't have gone that wrong if I'm only doing this every 5 years, right? Right? And we all grow. We all change. We settle. I'm a older woman now, and my needs have changed for clothing. You know, I'm working from home now. Things have changed. So you can't get too mad at me, universe. So now when you're shopping for new things, you can ask yourself, does this fit my core style as to what I have defined earlier from this video? How to actually separate and organize your clothing. I, of course, cannot mention the Marie Kondo method of doing things, of pulling every single thing out, holding the item, asking yourself if it sparks you, if it sparks joy for you, or if you love it, if it's a piece that you really know and love. I think that that works well, but I am not that decisive of a person. I cannot tell you that. I cannot do that. I am so wishy-washy. I'm a Libra, like, through and through. I have to, like, weigh every single pro and con of every single thing I've ever done.
I also have to mention, there are so many things that I absolutely love that spark so much joy for me. I love them. Why do I own 7-inch platform shoes that make me think of the 70s and ABBA and I'm in love with them and I've never worn them once? There are so many pieces I love, but they're not practical. And if we were only basing my wardrobe on things I love,
that sparks so much joy for me.
I probably wouldn't wear most of them, but I'm not sure it's the best ruler to measure my life with.
I feel like there are immediate no's, right? There are immediate no's that you know, and you're gonna put those in the pile. And then you have the big pile of maybes. And the best way I found to deal with the maybes is you take all of the maybes and you just box them up. And you just put them away out of mind. And then after an indeterminate amount of period of time, maybe 3 months, maybe 6 months, whatever it is for you, maybe a year, maybe you can go through all four of the seasons. And if you don't think about anything in that box, you don't open it up. You just donate it and you'll never have to worry about it ever again. So that's my biggest trick. I know that that's not for the fast acting or fast moving among us, but if you're like me, a little sloth out here, going at the speed of molasses, just trying to clean things up a little bit, this might work for you. So box them up, baby, put them away, and donate them in a year. It'll be excellent. It'll be great for you. It'll be wonderful. The things I absolutely love about shopping consignment is that if I take something home from a consignment shop, I only wear it 2 to 3 times and think, you know, honestly, I'm just not feeling this. I'm not wearing this as much as I should. I can easily just consign it back. And that just makes me feel a little bit better to think about it as something that is more temporary. And it's okay to let it go and live on for it to have another life. And there's something about thanking it and letting it go and being really kind to that purchase that I had that just makes me feel a lot better about it. Thanks for everything we've been through together. I really appreciated our time, but I think it's time for you to spend some time with someone else. And I know it's kind of like having a breakup conversation with your not so favorite dress, but sometimes that's what I need. I need to have that sense of closure. And I don't want you to be afraid of giving that closure to your things, because it might make it just a little bit easier for you to say goodbye. And if there is something you love that you don't really wear, that it's time for you to let it go. Also, don't be afraid of taking a picture of it. Sometimes I like to take pictures of things and say, hey, I'm gonna remember you. You'll always be on my mind, and I'll have a souvenir to remember you by. I actually have that of several pieces that I think fondly on, but just didn't currently serve me anymore, or didn't really fit in with my core style, but I can always look fondly back on those memories we had together. I feel like that Vitamin C graduation song just started playing. That is clearly what this video calls for.
As we go on, we remember all the times we had together.
I feel like this video is getting really long, although I found it to be entertaining. I hope you found it entertaining. Please give it a thumbs up if you did.
And give it a thumbs up if you didn't, because you made it this far. So clearly you watched the whole thing, right?
I would really appreciate it. And please press the red subscribe button to be notified when new videos are coming out. And if you would like to see an actual video of me going through all of my clothes, I will work on getting that done next week. I just feel like that deserves a separate video and walking you through my actual process as I try on a lot of these clothes and evaluate whether or not I think they fit into my life, if you think that would be helpful for you to see, or if you're just nosy about all the clothing I have and have accumulated over the last 5 years. So please thumbs up, subscribe, let me know in the comment section down below, and I will see you next week with a new video. Bye.